Hello, this is Ed Lenny. Welcome to another AFI 100 Greatest American Film Recipe Review. Today's film is The African Queen. The African Queen is a 1951 film, and it's directed by John Huston, starring Humphrey Bogart, Katharine Hepburn. The African Queen occupies 17th position on the 1998 list and the 65th position on the 2007 list. It won Bogart an Oscar. Humphrey Bogart's character is named Charlie Allnuts. He's a Canadian who is working as a mailman of the Uniga River, and Katharine Hepburn's character is Rose Sayer. Rose Sayer and her brother Samuel Sayer are missionaries from England. They operate a mission in German East Africa, which was a colony. This is September 1914, and the First World War started in March or April 1914. Charlie brings the mail and brings word that the world is at war. Germany is at war with England, Canada, and they don't really have all the details straight because, you know, they're all the way down in German Africa, and guys, it's like 104 years ago. Charlie's boat that he uses for mail is called the African Queen. Well, what happens is the German troops invade the mission and they burn it to the ground and they beat Samuel. Samuel is in shock because he's kind of posh, so he doesn't think that anything will happen to him, and what does, he ends up dying from his wounds and fever, leaving Rose alone. So Charlie M. Allnuts comes and basically rescues her and tells her that the African Queen, Germans will be back. They can take his boat, the African Queen. Now, Charlie is possessive of his boat, naturally, but he feels that the Germans, having just invaded Germany, Zabra, they don't have many supplies, and he has a lot of supplies on the African Queen. So that's why he's running from the troops. You know, he has all these medical supplies and gunpowder and food and whatnot. And so they go down the Uniga River, while they're traveling on the Uniga River, they had to plan to blow up the Louisa. Louisa is a German ship on cruising the Lake Tanganyika. So, because they know that once they get down to the Uniga, it'll empty into Lake Tanganyika, and they'll have to face the boat that patrols it. Now, this was a real boat. C.S. Forrester wrote a book in 1935 based the Louisa on the Graf Gosen, which was a real boat that patrolled that very lake. In preparation to meet the Louisa, Rose comes up with the idea of blowing the boat up. And Johnny says, oh yeah, I can make torpedoes from what I have on boat. You know, I have these nails and black powder and dynamite and stuff. And when we meet the Louisa, we can just go up to the side and blew it up right on the water line. So they'd start making torpedoes, which is it's an interesting first aid. Because, you know, it's Hollywood, you know, where we're going. What happens is they go through all these trials and, you know, bees, they get shipwrecked when they meet the lake, all this stuff. And they have to, you know, fix the boat in the water and they bond that way, blah, blah, blah. What happens when they meet the rabbit is they sink the African Queen and they get rescued by the Louisa. Basically, you know what's going to happen. This movie was marked by being one of the first big location films. John Huston didn't want to film in Hollywood in front of a screen because what would happen, you'd be on a soundstage, a big pool, and you would be on the center boat, and in the background they would have stock footage of an African river or the Amazon, whatever. But he wanted to have a real deal. You know, he wanted the feeling of Africa to just permeate this movie. So he didn't have any budget or any stars, but he sweet-talked everyone into giving him money, and he sweet-talked Bogie and Hepburn because he had made his first movie with Bogie. It was Maltese Falcon in 1941. So he had like heavy hitters from his first film. And he also directed Kid Argo with Bogie. So Bogie was throughout his career, his go-to actor throughout his career. Got Hepburn on board. He had the scriptwriter, one of the scriptwriters who was a grandiose, Peter Murtel, he told him to come with them to Africa, so they, you know, he'd finish his script in Africa to have that Africa feeling, and it was a disaster, man. It was like, just like Casablanca was a disaster. Doesn't look that way on film, but it was just they had a hard time building rafts around the African Queen because it wasn't big enough to have a camera crew on it. So they built rafts around it, and you know, now they do that with no problem, but back then they were learning on the job, and you know, they would be out in the middle of nowhere, and people need to go to the bathroom or have lunch, and they would have to shut down production, and the rafts wouldn't work. People would be standing on the riverbanks laughing at them because they've never seen a movie set because no one has. At one point, the African Queen sank. Like, not when it was supposed to sing after it happened, but it sank. And it shut down production for like 3 days. Because of all this turmoil, there were 2 books that came out. It was White Hundred Black Heart by Peter Benedict, which became a Clint Eastwood movie, and the other one was The African Queen by Kate Hepburn. And both of them were just recanting the horrors of shooting that film. But it's a good film. It's very talky. It's a dialogue film. It's kind of like, it's a dirty film, and that's why it's in here, and it's kind of romantic in parts, because, you know, you need a lot of romance if we only have 2 characters, and one of them, you know, male and female, you know, typical Hollywood. You need something to keep the audience invested. It's one of those things where the production was a mess. Movie's great, won Humphrey Bogart the Oscar. I like to have it on in the background sometimes. I don't really study it all that much because it's very talky. And my dad hates the fact that Rose constantly calls Charlie, not Charlie, but Mr. All that. And he just gets that because Katharine Hepburn has kind of a unique high voice, kind of raspy. Vocal cords are grating against one another, I guess, and drags on its nose, but I think you should see it if you want to know how to film a movie without much action, as in when I did an independent film. I didn't have the budget for explosions and stuff, so it just has to be more relationship-y. So I think this film, it's not as exciting as The Maltese Falcon, not as exciting as Casablanca, where you can switch locations, but it's a really good film. And once you've seen it, you keep on remembering these beautiful scenes of Africa and just being in Africa. It's different than being on a soundstage. People are getting hit in the head with like reeds that grow or overhanging foliage. It's the whole real deal. And that's what makes this movie special. If you like videos like that, please click like and subscribe, and I'm gonna make you more. And please visit my links in the dialog box below, because I'll has all my gear right now. I'm shooting on a 70D with a nice Tiffin filter. I hope you have a good day. We're having a warm day today. It's the AFC Championship day, and hopefully I can do and go see some movies when everyone's inside, so I can have more content for you. I hope you have a good day.